glad you're here for the service and life celebration of life for Frances Chauvin. She was such a beloved member of this church. And words like sweet, kind, compassionate, generous, sharing, always. When we think of her, that's what we think of. She had some time away from us in between her second husband, but she came back. We were glad she did. And I know her children were glad that she did as well, and the grandchildren. So we invite the Lord's presence here as we celebrate her life and God's goodness to her. That's what we'll be doing. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his namesake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup overfloweth. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And that's Fran's fate. Let's rise to sing, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Thank you. You may be seated. Our Old Testament reading for this celebration of life for Fran is found in Isaiah chapter 25, verses 6 through 9. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all people a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wine, of rich food full of marrow, of aged wine well refined. And he will swallow up on this mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. And the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces. And the reproach of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, behold, this is our God. We have waited for him that he might save us. This is the Lord. We have waited for him. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The epistle reading is found in Romans chapter 8, verses 31 to 39. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died. More than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The Holy Gospel is from John chapter 5, verses 24 through 29. Please rise. Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life. He does not come into judgment, but is passed from death to life. Truly, truly, I say to you, an hour is coming and is now here, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself. And he has given him authority to execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man. Do not marvel at this, for an hour is coming when all who are in the tombs will hear his voice and come out, those who have done good to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to the resurrection of judgment. We now confess our true Christian faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed found in your bulletin. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We continue to stand as we sing In Christ Alone.
You may be seated. What powerful words that hymn has. So true. May only His word be spoken, only His word heard. Amen. I've entitled the message, Ever Faithful. What a tremendous privilege it is to give the message at Fran Lawson's. I have to stop, and I want to say Chauvin so bad all the time. But Fran Clausen's celebration of life. It was a pleasure to know her. And if you knew her, you would say the same thing. Pleasure to know her. She was a very, very good woman. I say ever faithful, referring to Fran's dedication to the Lord, but the Lord being faithful to her in Jesus Christ. She was ever faithful to worship Him. She was ever faithful as a wife, ever faithful as a mother and grandmother, faithful in her friendships, faithful in her generosity, faithful in her loving kindness toward everyone. In her later years, she had some health challenges. You know, I've read where a nurse once said, "No one is more self-centered than a sick person." But that wasn't true with Fran. It wasn't. She was always thinking of others. In my years of knowing her, she was compassionate, caring for others, the opposite of self-centered. I wish I had a whole church full of people like her. The Bible tells us in our gospel lesson reading that on the last day of the world, all will rise. Those who have done good will live, and those who have done evil will be condemned. It is either heaven or hell, and there is no place in between. But if you don't know the Bible very well, you could conclude falsely that it's our works and how we lived our life that means heaven or hell. But that would be wrong. Because the fact of the matter is the Bible says no one is good. No, not one. It says that all have fallen short of the glory of God. No one measures up. Fran, as a sincere believer in Jesus Christ, knew that to be true of herself, that she was saved by faith in the grace of Jesus Christ. Any goodness on her part issued from the grace she was given by Jesus. The Word of God tells us clearly in Ephesians 2, for it is by grace that you are saved through faith, that not of yourselves, it is a gift of God, lest anyone should boast. And then it follows up by saying that we were made God's workmanship, created in Christ, to do good work, which God prepared us in advance to do. Well, Fran's a great example of this truth. Jesus poured his love into her life, as he does every Christian, and it bore fruit. The evidence of her faith was her good deeds, her attitude, which I think was exceptional. Her loving, caring attitude. She knew she was a sinner. She was flawed like all of us are. She knew that she constantly needed Christ's forgiveness. There's no boasting or bragging about our lives. We humbly know what we have been forgiven for. We know there have been sins in our life that we're conscious of and sins we're not conscious of. But the ones we're conscious of, we know what the grace of Jesus Christ has meant to our life. Fran knew this. In fact, anyone bragging that they are really good or better than others, it's disparaging the grace of Jesus Christ. Disparaging it. In fact, if you trust in yourself and your goodness and your religiosity, you will never have a lasting assurance of going to heaven. You will never know if you were good enough or religious enough. You won't know. Jesus secured our salvation for us. His death on the cross was payment for our sins. He finished the work that the Father had given him. That's what he said from the cross. It is finished. We all know what that means. He paid the price for our sins. He took our place. He was our substitute. The shortest psalm in the Bible is Psalm 117. Praise the Lord, all you nations. Extol him, all you peoples, for great is his love toward us. And the faithfulness of the Lord endures forever. If you want to be encouraged, because if doubts come to your mind about where you stand with God, as they do for all Christians, by the way. They do. We wonder, does this sin put us over on the ledger, right? If you want to be encouraged, go to the Word of God and look up verses that speak of his unfailing love and his faithfulness. For instance, Hebrews 13:5. Never will I leave you. Never will I forsake you. Romans 8, which we heard, nothing will be able to separate us from the love of God that's in Christ Jesus. And there are countless verses like that. And here's the thing to know about God's love. Unlike our love, it's not capricious. What I mean by that It's not given to sudden, unaccountable changes. It's not fitful, not a fluctuating thing. It's a constant thing. God's unfailing love, constant, can be trusted. I'll tell you why that's such a good thing. If bad things happen to us, we can trust God's plan that He'll work it all out for our good. Because bad things are going to happen to your life. Unless Jesus comes tomorrow, bad things are going to happen to your life. And that's when you'll be tested. Do you believe in the unfailing love of Jesus Christ? Or do you not? Fran believed in it. That I'm sure. Jesus is watching over all of His children. He will not let you fall if you look to Him. Experiencing the death of two husbands, who needs to go through that? No one, right? She remained faithful to her God, even as He was faithful to her. Well done, good and faithful servant, is a line that comes from the parable of the tenants. For Fran, it fits. There is in store for her a crown of righteousness, won for her by Jesus Christ. She will be welcome into heaven because God is faithful, and that's exactly what He promised through Jesus Christ, eternal life. And what a joy to think about heaven. You know, at every funeral, we need to highlight heaven because we're going to be heading there. It helps us through the troubles in life. In Isaiah 25, you heard that reference about heaven. What does it say? Heaven will be about great food. What's your favorite food? I'm sure it'll be there in heaven, right? Ribeyes, yes, if you're a vegetarian. Well, you don't have to be anymore. Okay, I don't mean to offend any vegetarians, but right. Great food, great wine. Now, if you're worried about alcohol, you don't have to worry about it in heaven anymore. For us Lutherans, it'll be great beer. Right? No pain, no death. Goodbye arthritis. Goodbye psoriasis. Goodbye cancer. Goodbye Crohn's disease. Whatever you have here, goodbye to that. No death, resurrected bodies, youth, vibrancy. It'll all be there for us. Heaven is a place where all the joys of earth will be greatly magnified and sadness will be eliminated. So whatever you liked, enjoy doing here, think of it magnified. You can't even imagine it. But we need to fix our eyes on heaven because this is what's promised to us. And Christians down through the ages have done that. We're heading toward heaven. And maybe the greatest thrill of heaven will be, we'll finally see God face to face. And we'll understand the Trinity, which is hard for us to understand right now, you know. And we'll see Jesus. Jesus who will still be in the flesh. God, true God, true man, it doesn't end for Jesus. And to see Him. But then we'll also see our loved ones. And maybe family members that your great, 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 great grandfather, grandmother that you never knew, but who were believers. It'll be exciting. You'll see the Chauvins of way back, the Clausen, right? What a family reunion this is going to be. You know, our days on this earth go by very quickly. Fran's life is a calling to us to be like her, to be faithful. Faithful to love our Lord and worship Him, and faithful to all the people that God has put in our path along our route. We grieve and rejoice almost simultaneously. That's what a Christian funeral is like. We grieve, we rejoice. We rejoice, we grieve. We will miss Fran, But we're glad that she was heaven bound and that she was in our lives. Let's thank the Lord for her being in our life. May we believe and be faithful as she was to the moment of our death. Thank you, Jesus. In his name, amen. Francis G. Clausen, age 70, passed away on May 22, 2022 at the University of Tennessee Medical Center. Francis was a loving mother to two sons and an amazing grandmother to five grandchildren. She was a faithful member of Grace Lutheran Church. Indeed, she was. In her free time, she loved to bake and read. She loved to serve others and had a very giving heart. Frances loved all animals, especially her two dogs, Stella and Ollie. Do they have a new home? Good. Frances is preceded in death by her husband, Bruce Clausen, 2013. Husband, Daniel Chauvin, 1998. Parents, Charles and Esther Gibbous. She is survived by her sons, Danny, wife Christy, Chauvin, Patrick, wife Ashley, Chauvin, grandchildren, Nicholas Chauvin, Tripp Chauvin, Max Chauvin, Nora Chauvin, Marley Chauvin, siblings, Charles Chuck Gibbous, Teresa, husband Joseph Green, Greg, wife Helen Gibbous, several nieces and nephews, and a host of loving family and friends, including her church, fellow church members who loved her dearly. There'll be no remarks here. We pray now. Lord, we thank you for the life of Fran Clausen Chauvin. We thank you, Lord, for all that she meant to us, O Lord. She was an example to us of how you can be sweet to everyone, even those most annoying people that we have in our lives. We thank you for that. We thank you for that loving smile of hers, that graciousness that she carried her life. We also thank you for giving her such a enduring faith in you, Lord, which, O Lord, she has passed on to many. We thank you, Lord, for having known her. And we pray, O Lord, that all the people here today will also have that kind of faith. Know that the grace of Jesus Christ has been given to all. If we but receive it, just receive it. O Lord.